For more than 20 years, CTV has captured the moments that matter in our community. From our studios in St. Clair, you're watching Focus with Paul Dingeman.
Well, joining us now from St. John River District Hospital is the Chief Medical Officer, Dr. H. Lee Bacheldor. Welcome back to the Focus Show, sir. Thought it was important that we get you in to discuss lots of things that have been in the press and on social media. Lots of rumors going on about the hospital, and we thought we'll get the Chief Medical Officer to come in and talk to us about just exactly what's happening.
Well, good. Thank you for the opportunity, Paul.
Where are we at? What's the future look like?
So we are still an acute care hospital. We are still there. We still have all of our services. We still have our emergency room, our radiology, imaging services, surgery, and inpatient care.
Okay.
We recently went through a right sizing, so to speak, and it's happening all across the country.
It really is, isn't it?
Healthcare is changing. Healthcare change is kind of the word for healthcare. 85% of healthcare is delivered in the outpatient setting, not in the inpatient setting. And so across the country, we're seeing people not being admitted to the hospital, probably accredited to the fine care that physicians are providing to their patients. So they're becoming healthier. We're getting on top of some of those chronic illnesses. We have different ways to treat those chronic illnesses in the outpatient setting, so people really aren't getting admitted to the hospital.
So in the old days, you'd go in for whatever, you have a bad cold or for a little surgery, you might be there 3 or 4 days. And now you'll go home the same day.
You go in for a heart attack, you were there for 30 days sometimes.
Yeah, right.
You know, now you go in for open heart surgery and you're out in 4 days. So it really has changed. Gallbladder surgeries, abdominal surgeries, a lot of those have been done in the outpatient realm, meaning you go in one day and you're out either that night or the next day, you're back home again. They're now not pushing to do, but they've made advances so they can do outpatient orthopedic surgeries, knee replacements and hip replacements. They have to select those people right and make sure that they have the resources at home that they can, and make sure that we have resources we can bring into the home. But there's been a lot of advancements made, so people really don't need to stay in the hospital.
Which means that there's open beds, which means you better get the right size to your hospital or you're not going to be around.
Correct. And so there's a lot of excess bed capacity throughout the country, and that's a term that a lot of administrators use. And so everybody's kind of looking at and changing and figuring out how they're going to fit in. Now, we're a small community hospital. We've always been a small community hospital. We take care of the bread and butter health issues very well. And we have that connection with a level one trauma center with all the specialty care at St. John Hospital Medical Center, and also Macomb Hospital, Providence, and Providence Park Hospital. And by the way, Providence Park Hospital just got top 100 hospital for their 10th year in a row.
Marvel.
So we're affiliated with some great institutions. So, you know, you come into our ER, if you're having an acute stroke, we have that stroke robot. People get on, you know, they get on the robot right away. They talk to the neurologists and the interventional neurosurgeons. And if there's an opportunity to do something right away to help recover and protect that brain, you know, they're able to do that. And we can send them to different facilities to do some amazing things now.
Talk to me about the maternity ward. You're going to make some changes there.
Yes. So we've invested some money into the hospital to kind of, as we said, right-size our hospital. So we still have an OB ward, and we provide, you know, OB care to those underprivileged persons in the county. So we're making our OB unit, which is a big, spacious, really nice unit.
Yeah, it is.
But we're kind of making that into one whole unit for the hospital, and it gives us some economies of scale. So we're going to have both on one half, and it will be separated. So one half will be the acute care services, the medical surgical patients. The other half will be the OB patients. So then we'll be able to share some staff, so that'll help us with some economies of scale.
What would the, you said critical care, but it's all pertaining to maternity.
Right, so we don't have, that's medical surgical care.
Okay.
So our ICU, which really was kind of a step-down ICU, has gone away. When people need to be in an ICU, they're really sick nowadays. Especially people need to be admitted to the hospital, they're really sick. So, you know, we really had an ICU that was functioning more as like a step-down unit. So we can still provide some of those for services at the hospital, but when you really need intensive care, you need to be in a facility that has a physician and staff, you know, medical staff and physicians there staffing it 24 hours a day. There's been a push for a long period of time to make sure that ICUs function in that way. So we're affiliated with St. John Hospital and Macomb Hospital, which both have great ICUs and do great care of patients.
Okay. Operating room will stay pretty much the same. You got the lab, the radiology, the physical therapy, all those things will still be around.
Everything is still there. We're still open for business. We're just kind of right-sizing ourselves to what we've seen over the past year. Everybody's doing that, even in industry. If you talk to folks in industry, they go through this sometimes more frequently than we do. You know, just looking at, you know, what they've done over the past and how are they making sure that they're right-sized to what they're serving.
The hospital has had such great history here in the Blue Water area. Mm-hmm. It was originally, as you mentioned, a community hospital and was funded by taxes from the municipalities from St. Clair down to Algonac.
Yep. And seven different communities, you know, gave tax dollars. And then St. John Providence, which was Ascension now, bought it out 10 years ago.
And that was great because you added all that support from a larger institution.
Correct.
And that's still going to be with you.
Right. Right, and those are things that we gain some, you know, expertise. We get our emergency room staffed by board-certified physicians, which are, you know, affiliated also with St. John Hospital Medical Center. So they work at both places. They have great relationships with all the specialists down there. So that helps us out. You know, St. John Providence is really committed to staying in the community. They are now looking for property in the county to build an outpatient center. They want to build in the southern part of the county.
Oh, really?
An outpatient center which has primary care, specialty care, and other ancillary services. So they're in the process of doing that right now. So they do have a commitment to the people in Southern St. Clair County.
You have an outpatient clinic on Fredmore Highway in St. Clair.
Correct.
The one you're talking about would be similar, or?
It's going to be probably bigger. Probably a bigger service facility, getting more primary care in the southern end of the county, and also some specialty care, and bring some of those specialists up from down south.
You know, when you look at Algonac, they've got a choice. They can come north to River District Hospital, or they can go a long, long, long way into 94
right.
from Algonac. So it's critical to have services in that area for those people.
Yeah. Yep. So contrary to what's on social media, we're not going away.
Good.
We're there. We're here to stay.
Good.
Yeah.
All right. Dr. H. Lee Bacheldor, Chief Medical Officer of St. John River District Hospital, plan on staying. We like to hear that news.
Good. Thank you, Paul.
We'll be right back.
Great. We cover everything?
Yeah.